Well, because of the imminent threat of large-scale extinctions, a lot of people really are worried about whether biodiversity matters or not. And this is a subject that we can study. And one of the most important studies of this sort has been done at Cedar Creek Nature Reserve, just north of the Twin Cities, by a professor here at the University of Minnesota, Dave Tillman. Tillman's studies look at biodiversity in a scale of these little plots in Cedar Creek. And each area has different numbers of plant species in it, ranging from 1 to 32. So some plants are growing up in monocultures, and some are growing up in quite diverse local systems. Now, in normal years, we have a fair amount of rainfall here in Minnesota, and plant life thrives. But every now and then, we get serious droughts. And it's those drought years that really taught important lessons about biodiversity. If you look at the biomass, that is the amount of plant material produced after a drought, it increases quite dramatically with the number of species in each one of these little plots. So these monocultures had very little biomass, but with two species, four species, much, much more biomass. And so there needed to be at least about 10 species in each one of these small plots for the plot to have still a thriving community after the end of the drought. We can also see this in our fisheries. The number of species in the oceans varies in different parts of the world. In far northern latitudes, up here, there are only several dozen species that are useful for fishing, whereas in the tropics, there are thousands of different species. Now, all parts of the world, the fisheries have been over-harvested, and we're starting to lose species from all of these different areas. And if we plot how many species still remain in different oceans around the world, we see that there has been a gradual increase in the number of species going extinct each year. That's this top line up here. And the cumulative number of species has also increased. So as we're losing more and more different species. Now, the rate at which these are being lost depends on the biodiversity in each system. So these rich systems with at least 500 different species are losing species at a lower rate. So here they're only losing 10% or so. And the cumulative total now is only about a quarter compared to these blue ones where the rates are higher and the cumulative loss is quite a lot higher. And so by now, in the early 2000s, there are many places in the north where over 80% of species have been lost, but in these rich species areas, only about half the species have been lost. So biodiversity helps protect against local extinction. And this matters in terms of how much food we manage to pull out of the ocean, because where we still have these more diverse systems, and this is on a log scale, so this would be 10 to the third, that's 1,000 different species, 100 different species. And so in oceans that still have 1,000 species in them, the productivity stays very, very high. We're getting a lot of food out of these oceans, whereas the less diverse systems, it's been lost. So it really does matter that we sustain biodiversity. We can see now that past catastrophes have obliterated much of the world's biodiversity at different points in time, every 50 to 100 million years, and that this biological complexity is important because it strengthens the resilience of overall ecosystems.